It's now 6:30, so I will call to order the select board meeting of Monday, November 13th. We will talk about minutes, and I think we'll, maybe we'll go right to the RFPs, and then we'll do highway. Is that?
That's fine, not no run.
All right, so from a hearing, from a minutes point of view, we have, it says public hearing at transfer stations, that's it, wait, this is the, I'm sorry, I'm looking at the wrong thing. Number one, approval of minutes. So the minutes that we were supposed to have read and commented on are November 6th, the special morning meeting that we had for the tax rate. November 6th, later that day, the public hearing on minimum housing standards, and then our regular meeting, November 6th.
I haven't read the minimum housing standard ones yet, can we hold off on those?
Absolutely.
I've read the others.
November, are we good with the special tax rate meeting and then the regular meeting, Mandy?
Yeah.
By consensus, Sally, those two done, we're gonna hold off on the minimum housing standards. Okay. We've been trying to figure out how to manage, we've got some sort of schedule things that kind of came our way here, some at the last minute. And so I think we're going to start by looking at the RFP proposals. And I hope someone has a.
Some remember.
Yeah, some way up, because it's up. Oh, you said, thank you, community input, while Michael is opening the first one in the community input.
I have a letter opener. All right, don't create an input, I'll just rip it open.
Anyway.
Sorry, I have a second.
All right, so what I would like.
You want them all open at the same time?
No, we'll just open them one at a time, and then let's have the name of the company.
First one is from Groen, GROEN Construction.
Just the, if there's a bottom line, I hope we ask for a bottom line somewhere. I don't want all of the details right now, just the.
That's good, but I'm not gonna go through all the details. There's a lot to read through. Give me a second. You know where these are?
I don't, I haven't looked at them.
Okay, you haven't looked at them yet.
This is the illustration from Groen.
Recommendations from people that have.
That's Groen.
That's not us, that's what they're working on. For residential and commercial buildings. I promise them more references. Which is good, they've got lots of references, that's a good thing. Try to find what the question you've asked me.
Do you have a name for your construction company?
Best Way Homes, out of Francistown, New Hampshire.
Found it, not the page I would have thought, yeah.
It's Best Way, two words on.
Two words.
Okay.
All right, so we're going back to Groen Construction for a moment, and they're out of, is this Rochester?
Rochester.
All right, you have a bottom line?
Total hard costs, $1,120,012.97. Pretty thorough estimate, that doesn't end in a zero or five.
Just giving this.
And then, you saw that, but.
Yeah, yeah, thank you. So Best Way, did you find a bottom line for Best Way? I will commit it again, I obviously have a minimum missing.
$1 million.
Yes.
$100.
Yes.
$20 million.
No.
I don't remember, 97 cents.
$120 million.
$1,120,000.
$1,120,012.
Oh, so 012.
012.
Yeah, all right.
$0.97.
Okay.
You ready?
Yep.
$1,160,315 for Best Way Homes.
$1,160,315.
Yes.
Ritchie Construction, RICCI, or Ritchie.
Is that Portsmouth?
Portsmouth. Yeah, it's still up. Experience, schedule, safety, scope of work, how about the price? All right, they wouldn't just be having tabs, huh? No, just kidding. I don't want $1,197,000.
And that's $1,197,000.
Yep, 777.
No, I said $1,000,000.
$1,197,000. Hundred.
$1,000,000, $197,000.
$777. Yeah, there's actually about six copies. Who do you have, Jody? The benchmark?
$3,000.
Oh, all right.
Rainout construction. Do you have a return tower second?
Jody?
I didn't get that.
Portsmouth.
No.
Hold the tape. I'll report to you.
Who is it? Are we gonna get one?
Very thorough at a benchmark. They aren't taping those.
No, they're not from here. Jody doesn't have benchmark.
All right, do you want another company's name?
Yes.
Benchmark out of Westbrook, Maine.
One word, two words for benchmark.
Benchmark appears to be one word.
Out of Westbrook?
Westbrook.
Okay.
I don't get any further than that.
All right.
We'll cover that up for Richard, we'll go back in the box. Not bad. Ooh, cover.
Yeah, Pareto, Pareto.
Yep.
$1,237,000.
Even.
Thank you.
$1,237,000.
Get one.
Okay. And you're working on benchmark.
I'm working on them. They don't sound bad.
It wasn't a huge swing so far. Whatever that's worth. The really bigger things are quarter infrastructure.
We did benchmark.
Quarters in life.
And the best way is one more. And we did three sheets.
Yeah, I've got the.
And you got the last one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Trying to just say.
Well, how much was benchmark?
I haven't gotten there yet, tell me.
So there should be one more that Jody.
You think there was six?
I thought there was seven.
Best way, there's Crino, or whatever, Crino?
Crino.
Benchmark, which is in my hand. Richie. Richie gave us two. So maybe that's what you're thinking. That goes together. And then there's Bruin, Rowan. One, two, three, four, five, six. No, I just didn't.
No, we only have five.
We got me doing it now.
Okay, good point. We're quite sure. Bob, that'd be five. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
CVs or their engineers, sample projects. declarations. More references. Your liability insurance. So all they have, they don't have a bottom line, they have some estimates. Okay, Mark is very interested in the tours recent years. Anticipate starting construction, pre-construction spring 2018. Okay, construction budget, $200 per square foot. Civil design includes planning board and town meetings, $20,000. Mechanical, electrical, plumbing, design, engineering, $40,000 to $45,000. Structural design, engineering, $15,000. Architectural design, $20,000 to $25,000. They didn't give us a bottom line of the rest.
Okay, so.
So what do we think, what's the square footage we were envisioning down there?
About 6,500.
Well, we'll,
$1.39 million.
Without the addition of the other pieces.
That's the construction budget, and then all the rest of it on top of that, I'm assuming. And that's,
okay.
Where is that?
1.3.
Benchmark.
Okay, so.
Trying to find where to put it back.
All right, so just to kind of sum and wrap up, we had RFP responses from Growing Construction of Rochester, Best Way Homes of Francistown, New Hampshire, Ritchie Construction of Portsmouth, New Hampshire, Carino of Corinto of Portsmouth, New Hampshire, and Benchmark was Maine. They all have a clear stated bottom line except for Benchmark, and we just put it in this worksheet as 1.3 million plus the additional things. So I think the next step is for us to, obviously they're available to the board to look at, but.
Yeah, I would suggest that we take a copy downstairs and we'll put that checklist together.
Yeah.
And Mike can call a meeting of the committee, review them all, and then make some type of recommendation for what I would say.
All right, that sounds like the next best step. I mean, there are things that if you are hoping, expecting, whatever, to go forward in March, we will need more than just a construction budget because there's the logistics for moving, some idea of the maintenance, utilities, all those sorts of things that impact this building. You know, there's going to be a lot that we have to figure out. So this is one piece of it, and I suspect the search committee can help us, or hope that they can help us with these other pieces that I've started to think about things that we have to be thinking about in regard to all of this. So I'm happy to share with the committee. Are we all set?
One is just a color copy, the rest are.
Oh, okay. So they range from, you know, 1.12 million to 1.3 million plus. That's sort of the range for that. Any other questions, comments that we might want to make about the RFPs? Okay. Peter, nice to see you.
Hi.
We're going to do the highway department, and then we'll check back in with you.
All right.
That's okay. Is there anything else that you needed us for, Chief?
I just have one purchase order.
Perfect. Let's go.
Okay. Purchase order number 1315, mailed to the city of Dover. We need a set of tires for cruiser number 71, and a repair for tire sensor on cruiser 74. I'm estimating about $100 in labor for both of those, for a total of $900, and that will come out of line item 707, vehicle repairs.
The Move to accept purchase order 1315, City of Dover, for tire repairs on Cruiser 74, 71, including labor, for a total of $900.
Second.
Any comments or questions? All those in favor say aye.
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 Thank you.
Are we good?
We're good.
All right, George. Okay. It's always best to come to, you're supposed to come here. So it'll take, you know, just.
And that, it'll happen.
It'll happen.
I know, I mentioned it last week, it's, you know, we do it, but.
It's the purchase order that is the legal, yes, it's okay to do it. And that's what our auditors tell us we should do.
That's all.
Absolutely, no worries.
Okay, move to accept purchase order 981 to Pike Industries for 40 ton of gravel for Cowan Drive and washouts at $875 a ton for a total of $411.25.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Oh. Oh, I thought you were just writing something. You were just writing, did you mention?
Yeah, I wrote that.
Oh, I think it was today, I'm sorry.
No, no, I'm just going to.
I can't.
The day I signed. Okay. And Mary?
I have a question.
Yes, so would you like us to go into non-public?
Yes.
All right. I don't think this will be too long, we hope, but Mike.
We'll go into non-public session for personnel.
Second.
Any discussion? Not any discussion. A roll call of whether we want to do this. Michael?
Yes.
Jody?
Yes.
Suzanne? Yes. So there was no action from the last non-public. And we are probably, there's chat.
We are.
So we're going to go into non-public again to review an elderly exemption with Mr. Mantos, assessor, Chad Rogers. Sorry.
Don't sit, Mark. We're going into non-public.
Going in non-public.
Sorry.
Deal with exemption.
Okay, roll call, Michael.
Yes.
Jody?
Yes.
Suzanne, yes. Okay, sorry about that.
No.
A petition.
It sounds like it's lucked out.
Yeah.
So you need to get 25 signatures, you need to get a language.
Have it posted.
It would have been a sadder story if you had it installed but not yet inspected, so it wasn't connected yet, and you lost your power. That would have been.
Well, I had to call, get it inspected.
On the community bulletin board.
Have a good evening.
Yeah.
Disability, I can't go door to door.
I think the community bulletin board that's out there should work.
Okay, all right. Because, I couldn't do that. I can understand that if it was partisan issue, but it's not partisan issue.
It's not partisan at all. You know, what would be helpful is if, you know, you might want as a model, I don't know, we, here when we first passed it, but there would be language, and you could just kind of print the language.
Okay, all right. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Peter.
All right, thank you.
Yep.
Sorry.
Chief Rutherford.
Hello.
Hello. We have to wait for us to be completely assembled, but if you wanted to.
I got it.
Come up, have a seat, be comfortable.
Thank you.
There's two of us. Bring yourself at home. Do you have non-public too?
I don't.
Oh, come on.
Yay.
I did mine. I'm done with that.
I
That's true, but, all right, go.
I don't mind waiting.
He should be, I don't know where he, I think he was just putting something away. Here it comes, please.
Okay, two purchase orders. This is the end of the year, it's the time when we do our protective clothing procurement. So, the first one that I have is purchase order 1247. It's the Bergeron protective clothing, and it's for $1,702.42. It's for personal protective equipment that you guys need. Helmets, gloves, boots, all that good stuff.
Purchase order number 1247 to Bergeron protective clothing for assorted personal protective equipment for $1,702.42.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor, say aye.
Aye. You have another one, so I'll, wait.
And again, it's this next one of mine, it's 48, it's the Bergeron. They prefer to send two, because that stuff's sitting in my office, because it's already been delivered, so we can pay the bill. This is the other half, this is for the, every 10 years is a service life for, guys' gear and equipment, so we have a running chart. And this year we had to purchase two coats and one set of pants. So, yeah, it's Bergeron protective clothing. This stuff won't be in for 30 days or better, so I'm gonna submit the PO now, just so that it's covered on in. And that's for 2663 change for the new clothing. The other one is basically for the accessories, that's the important stuff. And all that comes out of the protective clothing line item, and that's the first anything that we spent out of is those two purchase orders. So the balance is six, that way there's 40 something, so there's gonna be money left over in that amount. And I got earmarked or something.
I'm sure.
Move to accept purchase order 1248 to Bergeron protective clothing, two Global firefighter jackets and one Global firefighter pants for the amount of $2,663.35.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Now this is a new invoice I can keep with me.
Yeah, they don't do that stuff. That's just the cost of doing business. The one thing that we've been able to arrange is anywhere from 3 to 5 sets in the air is what we go for. It keeps us from our budget. We've got it spaced out, so these guys stay.
Do you want this one back, or do we keep it?
You can keep it. Okay. As things come due, we're going to spend our money.
So I'll be sending an email out to department heads, but you know it is important to get this stuff, start to give it to us now so that we can make sure it stays in the right fiscal year. So,
as much as that as I can. And we've been getting most of that stuff up because I know I was in the other day, hose is taken care of, the protective clothing in is taken care of. I got a bill sitting on my desk I need to do because we have some repairs done in the forestry. That should be the last vehicle repairs to the end of the year. And that'll be the last time we put those in. We're just going to grab some of the funding that's in there, some of the extra parts we're going to put on the fire truck. There you go. They will deliver our command vehicle.
Absolutely.
I don't know, it's been 6 weeks, they keep talking, it's coming, it's coming, it's coming. And there's three white
ones. We've done the purchase order.
There's three white ones sitting up there, and you're going to go get one and drive it back.
We've done the purchase order, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I did that when they first told me it was coming. I must have submitted that close to 2 months ago, because I know it was still sitting in Caroline's box. And when I was here the other day, we looked at it. I wanted to get the invoice so I could get the... Actually, I was asking her exactly what she needs for registrations and insurance purposes and stuff. You know, she needs some VIN numbers and all that, so we've been hounding and hounding. So it's coming, it's coming, it's coming. But so it's Christmas. Hope to have it before then.
That's all right.
But I want to get that in and get it done and get it sent to two way, get it out of it, because that's one of the chunks of stuff that we need here to make up for a little extra funding beyond the war hawk. And that will give you a very good total on where I'm at with the extra pieces for the fire trucks. So. Stumbling.
Yeah. It's not helpful when people aren't proceeding at pace the way you want them to.
Yeah, well, especially when they tell you, when they can't live up to their promises, it's the frustrating section.
Do you have an idea what, I mean,
it's
Is there something particular about this vehicle that makes it rarer than?
Nope. Not rare.
I mean, it's a little different than what you would go if you're buying a Tahoe off the lot for your own personal use. It does have a little bit different, like Chief Ducharme's buying one or something for his police stuff. There's extra amenities that are in it. It's the same thing on the fire side. It's just that I think that for whatever reason, we keep shipping more than we're supposed to have somewhere else. We're going to address it again this week. Hopefully, we can come in here and have it done.
All right. Sounds good.
That's all that. Anything else for me?
All right. Thank you. Have a nice evening.
Thank you, too.
Thank you for your patience. Okay.
Thank you, you too.
So I realized we didn't talk to George about some of the things that we wanted to talk to George about. But I did send him an email today about the first chipping at the transfer station from a budgetary point of view. I asked him if he thought 10 hours, budgeting 10 hours a month was sufficient. He said yes, so we'll work that into the budget. I think highway shed loft stairs, we already have that in the budget, so there was nothing else to say about that. Kelwin Drive, he did update us on Kelwin Drive. And transfer station, the Lamprey Trucking Cooperative. Anything more to say about that, Joe?
No, they're meeting this week, I believe. We're just going for me. We'll have to check that. Yes. This Friday. To see what they're going to do with the truck, where it's going to be hauled, if they're going to pay it off. Lots of questions up here with that.
Okay.
So
it has.
Who's for?
George. So it has, obviously it has real budgetary implications because
yes.
We've got our budget based on so much per haul, so the sooner we can figure out what that is and how many hauls I think we're going to do.
And I told you I already reached out to Shipyard, and Shipyard can haul at the waste management if we can't get out of our waste management contract, if the trucking group falls. They will also take it to their own facility for a little bit more income. So
what, when if they were to agree to haul to waste management, would it be under contract? Would it be just like per month, like we do now with our?
It'd be mileage, and it'd be less mileage, and right now going is about five something, about what we're paying now.
Okay.
So it's less mileage.
So safe.
Right. So depends on where the other towns fall. Epping is willing to house it, but we don't have a dispatch or a chairman. At this point, and another town would have to step up. And then we'd have to pay from Epic. And then if we pull out, if we're the only ones that pull out, then everybody else's trucking fee goes up. So, but.
Yeah, and if they're going to be able to
pull out over the air, Stratton is pulled out over the air.
Right, that's not a problem.
No, but we would have a,
yes,
a fee, right? Closeout fee or however you do.
Yes,
yeah. So we need to know what that
the
is.
The burden of leaving them.
Right,
it's
less issue than
it's not an issue, it's the payment to get out.
Yeah.
So.
All right, so it'd be nice to know what that is. I know, you know, it's not us that alone that's making this decision, so we just have to be patient. Thank you for the report.
Where are we with the old highway shed over on Silver Street?
Seems
to have fallen off the
Burke has never reached back out to me. Chief asked to.
He didn't want that stuff.
And so.
I would say that's off the table right now.
He did. Chief said he did get quotes of demolition for that. But he never gave us a number.
Okay.
So it's off the table.
I'm sure we have plenty of excavators in town that would have fun carrying that.
Okay. Anything else? All right, we've opened the RFPs. We should probably think about sending an acknowledgement letter. Okay, I'll talk to Caroline about that. Town administration project updates. Oh man, so we're still hoping to have a signing party next Monday, but we need final figures, so I'm starting to to assemble them. I've got a final invoice from our bond counsel. I received the payout from KSB, Kennebunk Savings Bank. It's really the final pay rec in Will Tanner, so we really need to get those figures to us this week. So stay tuned. That's about all I can say, stay tuned.
There is something in here for us to sign for their bond.
Who's bond?
Parker's bond. It's the town. For their work.
All right, we should probably wait till after the final pay rec, I think.
Okay.
Just to make sure everything is totally closed out. So I guess they just asked, this bonding company is wanting to know that it's complete.
Correct.
I don't remember doing it for anybody else, but maybe we did and just don't remember.
Were satisfied with the repaving and all that?
They passed, the only thing that was still on the punch list is the grass. You know, that was it. So we're sort of waiting around watching the grass grow.
They planted it, huh?
Yeah.
No.
But it got washed out once.
So the pumpkins aren't really growing probably right now. It's a little chilly.
It's a little chilly. We'll see what happens. And the Army Corps of Engineers, something that Will Tanner will do for us again when everything else is. All right, transfer station fees. So we had a public hearing on fees, and there are two things that we are proposing. One is the transfer station sticker fee to $20 per sticker for whether it's one or two or 30 stickers that you want. And the other is the Freon, right, for, is it Freon? What are we proposing to increase the Freon to?
Oh, that's right. He said we had.
Yeah, it's on the notice. It's on the public hearing. Nobody talked about it, but.
Because we had talked, we just never made a motion back in the January.
I think you did.
We voted.
I think you did. You didn't sign anything. There was no copy. So it was just like an incomplete process. So we'll just kind of make it a complete process. I just don't know what the amount is to. Suggested we for a motion to vote on. $15 to $20. That's what I'm seeing from the. What was proposed at this public hearing in the January meeting. So I will entertain probably two motions: one for transfer station fee, one for Freon.
Said that the public notice was mentioned before.
It did. It was on the posted.
It was 10 to 15.
No.
15 to 20.
Sorry.
Make a motion to change the crayon-related items at the transfer station from $15 to $20.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
And we will know that, and we'll get the signing, we'll get the documents ready and sign them next week. Okay.
Make motion to have transfer station fee stickers at a flat rate of $10 only for stickers. No, the second sticker would still be $10.
You sure you want 10?
Yes.
And not 20?
I'm listening to the public.
Well, then there's no change. We're not changing, so we don't have to.
Yes, we are changing. Where the second sticker right now is 5.
Oh, I see.
And that's what the, that's what our auditor didn't like.
Right. All right, any discussion? I will just say that the public was 2 people, right, and the town is
second.
A lot more.
Anyone second it?
I will second the motion. So, I mean, I understand that, I guess I'm just surprised that, one person or perhaps a second person would be sufficient to change our mind for what, at least the two of us, for what was a
Oh, I totally agree, but, you know.
So we're gonna have to.
If they'd rather come up with it in taxation, then.
All right, it's not gonna be helpful for our budget, because it's sort of been built in at this point, so just letting us know that it's gonna have to come from somewhere else. If not as revenue from there, it's gonna have to come from somewhere else.
Yeah.
All right,
well,
so
we listen to 10 people at town meeting, we listen to, you know.
Well,
when you talk about paving roads, there's only 8. So.
Well, I understand, but I guess my point is, listening, yeah, I guess I am, because, you know, it's still up to us to apply our own judgment on what we think the right thing is to do for the town. You know, so we're listening to people, but if we think it's still a right thing, that that's an appropriate thing for us to do, then it's then we should vote that way. So I guess I'm just surprised, that's all. So, but so there's a vote for a flat $10. A motion for a flat $10 increase. I just said my piece. Like, any comments or questions?
No.
All right, I'll call the vote, and all those in favor say aye.
Right.
All those opposed, no. I would say no. Doesn't pass. So now we have.
Now you're 10 and 5.
Now we're, yeah, there's no change, 10 and 5.
Now your auditor's not happy.
What would you like me to do out of this bunch of lemons? You know, I don't know where to go.
I was looking to compromise. Apparently no one else is.
In my judgment.
I'm trying to make the residents happy and our auditor happy.
In my judgment, it was an appropriate thing for us to consider raising the transfer station fee to $20. I still think it's appropriate.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not going to, based on Mark, who was the strongest, and Celia, who was another, just, it didn't affect my judgment. I understand what they said, and I'm sympathetic. It doesn't change my judgment. My judgment remains the same. So I'm not going to vote against what I don't think is the correct thing, most appropriate thing to do.
Okay.
So the fee is then $10 and $5. There's been no change. Any comments on the September Treasurer's Report?
No.
I don't think we did. Front Office Director, that probably is there just to remind us that it's happening in December. We don't have any information on the best deployment of the current Front Office Printer, so we'll table that. Recreation, I think that's there just to remind us that we need to have some.
Yeah, I checked in. The Dover Pool won't accept credit cards.
The bowling alley? The
Dover. Dover.
The Dover Pool.
Oh, I think the Dover Bowl. I'm like, really? That's crazy.
No, they do. I know they do.
Have you had any opportunity
to... Yeah, I'm congested. I'm so sorry.
Yeah, any opportunity to check on models for how other communities you know, run the finances for their programs.
While Dover is its own entity, so they use their pool. We are the only other place that uses the pool for my knowledge. Because we use it on Friday afternoons, but no one else does.
I think I didn't ask the question correctly. I'm just looking for, here's my concern is that we have a line now that is 75,000, I think, or more, you know, that section, it's a couple of lines. And, you know, other departments that have bottom lines of that amount or more are either headed by an employee who reports to us like the chiefs, and or they have trustees, like the cemetery trustees have a set of, and then the library trustees. So there's some sense that of somebody watching the chicken coop or whatever it is. And it's just a bigger number, and you know, we need to, how do we have confidence that revenue is going to come in? And we can talk some more about that on Saturday.
Okay.
I assume we'll still be able to do a budget workshop Saturday.
I think we have to.
Not at 9. I can't.
What time?
I'm going to be here at 11.
11?
Or 10. 11. 11. You can't be here before 11. Perfect.
11 o'clock? All right.
A late night on Friday. So I'll be out of town. And I am sorry. There's no way I better be here on Saturday. I do a thank you.
It's difficult.
Deal, so
you can see they're big.
They're not 100% for that.
Big issues.
Well, the only reason why it's up that high is because we're looking into the teen program. So we have a select board can say no to the teen program.
I mean, the answer, though, I think this is answer to your question. The way I understood your question is, how do these other towns do it? They have full-time departments that handle it, right? Like Dover has a rec department, right, that handles,
yeah,
that has employees that do it. So we've got to figure out.
They have a staff of 5.
Yeah, we have
so
a volunteer committee of 6 or 7 or whatever they are. So 12, I don't know. Yeah.
So there were two questions, actually. One,
I got the first seven.
Yeah, I confused the issue. So what are some models for small towns that run rec programs? There must be some somewhere. And just the fact that there's, you know, this, and I don't want to not support it, I'm just saying it's an exposure, right? Because, you know, I didn't do the math, but if we don't get the revenue next year to the extent that we didn't get it this year, it's a bigger number, right? So.
Well, I think part of your answer is what some of the work that the committee, Jody's committee, all jokes, she's not a rep to it, but the rep did as part of their homework to pitch the original idea. Like, so with Dee and
Kelly,
and there's one other person who suddenly came up to us. Well, maybe the one who came in.
Serious one.
Yeah, but when they first came to us, there was two ladies that came in. I think it was Dee and Kelly.
Mm-hmm.
And said they were going to research, and they did research other towns and how they were, they wanted to replicate it, their idea that they want to ramp up the field, which is wonderful. So I think part of that has been done. I think the question is, are we satisfied with the system that's been developed?
I think it's the rates that they were researching.
No, I think they looked at how, like the responsibilities of the counselors, responsibility of the part-time rec director or camp director, whatever you want to call it. So that they were, and like how the kids were signed in and out. So they were trying to replicate a system that exists in other towns. I mean, my larger point is, perhaps we can ask them, I understand if they're still volunteers, maybe to bring in some of that information to us, and we should look at it again, and we can decide whether or not we think it's still a prudent model. But I don't disagree with you, Sabina. It's getting to a point where $75,000 is quite a bit of money. So I think we all three of us share a concern, you know, obviously that we need the revenue to offset it, but.
Well, I know they're presenting at the budget committee, so those questions are going to be asked. So we can wait to see what the budget committee's input is. But
we could, yeah. But I just wanted.
It doesn't
to
answer
sure.
my question about
right.
how best to manage.
The
bottom line is one thing. How, you know, how does one manage? Do they have separate checking accounts? Do they have a top credit card? How do they apply the appropriate controls? it's a lot more money that's going to be funneling through hands, and so, you know, it's our...
Would you sit down with Tom, our auditor, and see the best way to handle this?
That's one approach.
Okay.
That's a possibility.
Okay.
And then we could also ask the committee leaders, I mean, the entire committee, to come in the camp they want, but maybe to come in and sit with us and have a conversation with her as well. See what worked well last year, where they think that needs to be improved, and where we think that additional protocols need to be put in place.
Well, we've had that financial discussion, I think, with Caroline, so...
Okay. Because in my mind, the credit card is a much safer alternative to a check. I know that seems counterintuitive, but I remember during my tenure as treasurer, I would meet with the folks over at Citizens Bank, and the government relations folks from Citizens Bank, and they tried to convince the town that it would be in our best interest to move away completely from checkbooks. And we're issuing paper checks whenever possible because there's more opportunity for fraud with paper checks, with lottery numbers and all of that. The town didn't obviously move away from paper checks. We still issue them, but
we do have town credit cards.
We have some, exactly, my point. We do have town credit cards now, so it would be safer. You could also track it in real time too.
Exactly.
Or a day, later, sure. Or whatever. You know, it's versus a check that could be, you know, someone could make up with 3 or 4 checks from the middle of the checkbook. You may not know for a while. So.
Well, let's so why don't you sit down with Tom, see what he has to say. He's a stickler.
I just emailed Caroline for his email.
Okay, sure, I have it.
All right. Email in there something.
So we'll continue to talk about that. Annual holiday schedule, I'm sorry, I'm going to table it on. I do have one. I don't know exactly where it is right this very moment, so
as long as we do it by January 1st.
We will definitely have it done before then.
We'll be good.
The Old Mill Lane Bridge, I did complete an application. I got a template from Aaron.
Okay.
So. Again, I'm wondering if it's in our folder. If it's not, then I have it in my files and I'll bring it next week.
State Bridge Program?
State Bridge Program. Let's see if this is it. This is what we table, though. Yeah, this is what we table. So what's not here is the is this, which I filled out. So let me check at home and bring it in next week. So we'll table anything. Sorry about that.
Yeah.
Anything about to talk about with joint loss?
We don't meet again for a couple weeks.
Okay. Welfare, that's sort of table until after budget season. All right, so we're at, unless there's some other town business that I haven't thought of, it's not here on the agenda, we're gonna go to our, what we're about this coming week. Michael, anything up with you?
The historical committee meeting is tomorrow evening, right here, 7 o'clock.
Excellent. Jody?
What meeting is it?
Historical committee.
Landry's meeting this week on the 17th,
And is that the one that George is going to?
Yes.
That's excellent.
And then Joint Loss is meeting on December 4th. And EMS management planning is at 10 a.m. on the same day downstairs.
That's the emergency update to the emergency system. Surprisingly.
Oh, and REC meets on December 10th. And REC presents to the Budget Committee on December 6th.
You know, if they're willing to, it might not be a bad idea for us to sit down with them before that. If you think, you know, the chairs.
Here in public session?
Yes.
Okay. I will send them an email.
Mike?
Direct folks?
Yeah.
So you want to meet with them?
Probably, preferably, if they can come to us before the budget committee, that would be helpful.
If only one can make it, is that okay?
Oh, sure, absolutely, yeah. Okay. No building permits? Nothing in your folder?
But we are, we're gonna meet at 11 o'clock, you said, on Saturday?
Yes, 11 o'clock on Saturday, we'll post it.
Right now.
Okay.
So it's one that can happen, again, I am very sorry, but I just really have this one. By extension, I have to.
Okay. All right, so correspondence folder then.
Saturday, 8. Can I, is that, do we anticipate, how long do we have to do that?
Seven hours.
Three hours?
Couple.
Okay, I, could we usually have it locked up for 3 hours, so?
Yeah, we'll have to bring it into them.
I have an engagement with that evening.
Okay, let's hope we're not still here. Yes, that's true. That's why I just got up. Could you, we have a check for you in the office, if you don't mind me. Okay. Correspondence?
Get there, put it in.
Okay.
Your bond you wanted to wait on. Last week, we okayed a purchase order to Mark, purchase order 1283, for miscellaneous items, we just forgot to sign it.
I'm now signing it. Yes, we did.
In my folder was the New Hampshire Municipal Association bill and check for a conference registration in the amount of $150. And that's for the conference coming up for Caroline. And that is Wednesday and Thursday.
So where was? Oh, all right, this is just an FYI.
Yes.
All right, this falls within the, this falls within the threshold, so.
Yes.
So Caroline had talked to us about going, I didn't think she was going to, so she signed up for 2 days, is that?
Yes.
Okay. Any questions?
Yeah, who was the other one that you could go to, the annual?
This is the annual meeting.
The annual meeting or the summer?
No, the annual meeting is in, is at this time of year.
And this is usually in the checks folder, but it's the retirement system bill for the vouchers, so I signed that as well.
Okay, thank you.
So they just happened to be in here, but they weren't in this week. This is our, we need a signature for our health insurance. So this we looked over last week with our rate changes, and then there's a signature page.
I am signing the renewal rates for medical coverage for the period of January 1st, 2018, through December 31st, 2018. And the billing services, actually what I'm signing is the, are the billing services. So which says that we agreed to let them know what our enrollment is, so they know how to bill us. I'll be happy to read more, blah, 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 it's not sufficient, but.
That's it, everything else is old. Everything else we've already talked about or it's left. Did you want this for budget? Those are all our.
nonprofits.
I want them for the annual report as well as the budget, so.
Are you here for now?
Yeah, please don't give them to me.
Do not give you paper.
Got it.
All right, that was it.
All right, community input?
So Eli pulled, in reference to the rec committee, we have done research in other communities. I know that the chairs have reached out to Dover and Barrington and so much forth and gotten what they do in their programs and looked at it and we've discussed it as a group. I'm sure they would be more than willing to come in and talk to you about what they've found. I believe a lot of the surrounding communities do have an employee who runs the program. I know from some of the conversations of the committee that we have a goal possibly in the future to accept payment in other forms besides just checks. And I know South Berwick has a couple of employees and they also take credit cards through a website. And I don't know if that's, I know they're a municipal association in a different state, so I don't know if the rules apply there or not, but I have paid for rec activities through the South Berwick Rec Department online through their
There's
website.
There's no doubt that services like that are helpful. You know, it's getting us to the point to actually do the research, find out what it costs us, you know, all of this sort of thing. So, and it just, to date anyway, has not been the opportunity to do that. We have started the credit, I mean, you know, we take these little steps. We have credit card now for employees, which is a good thing. So that's a step, an improvement, I guess. So there are lots of ways that we can talk about to make that sort of thing happen. It's just the steps, you know, it's an ideal, but how do you get from here to there is one thing. But for me, it's just the overall increase in the amount of money and that it's, you know, we talked about, you know, Jody overseeing the employee that we'll hire to be the director, but it's the amount of money, so it's, you know, it comes in and out, flows in and out in several different ways, registration, selling stuff, selling popsicles. You know, there's all of these ways where it could be, you know, where we would want to have appropriate controls. And, you know, Tom will, you know, be happy to tell you what he thinks those are. It might also be helpful. He's going to be as restrictive as, because he's going to tell you what he, you know,
yeah.
He probably will tell you to count popsicles. So, you know, it just would be interesting to see, not Dover, not Barrington, I mean, smaller places like us don't have a full-time employee, not even a permanent part-time employee, see how they manage these kinds of.
And I know from looking at the South Berwick rec page is that they have a committee of only three, but I believe they oversee one or two employees of the town. So their committee is smaller, but I don't know. They're also a larger community.
Yeah.
And I think as we move forward and look at more options, it was the hope, my impression from the conversation we had within the committee was that by accepting like credit cards and check, it would open us up to more people who could not come up with the money up front but had credit cards as an option to pay for the summer camp, and it might bring in more revenue for the camp. So that was my impression, and for some people that would be another control, because you could, the money would go right into the town accounts, but maybe it's not, I don't know.
So New Durham, we always compare ourselves to. New Durham has two. They have a Parks and Rec director and a Kid Connection bookkeeper. So me and Kelly have more than willingly will take on these roles. Kelly's like, that would be my dream job. So.
Well, you know, at some point,
so
we may
get to that point.
We may get to the point where we have a, you know, a part-time rec director who works 6 months a year or seven, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
You know, if the bulk of that money is being paid for by the
by the fees of the people who are making use of rec, then, you know, town, you know, that's a model I think could work. Okay, any other community input?
Do we do it on public? Did I say that on
We've done that. It was, that was last, I'm sorry, that was last month's.
Okay.
And we talked about inviting that complainant here tonight.
You got it.
We did that. And so I think we're, I guess we're ready to adjourn. Anybody has a better opinion on that? All right, have a nice evening. It is 8:08.